My name's Professor Miles Prince. I'm a haematologist, which means that I specialise in the blood. In particular, I specialise in looking after patients with blood cancers. When people find out what you do, what's the most common question you get asked? The most common question I get asked is, what is haematology? And the answer is, it's about blood. And in particular, for me, it's about looking after patients with blood cancers. And there's three types of blood cancers: leukemia, lymphoma, and myeloma. How do you tell a patient they have cancer, and how difficult is that? It is probably one of the most difficult parts of my job. You can't hurry telling a patient about their blood cancer. What we have to do is tell them honestly and with compassion. What's changed in treatment and survival rates in the last 20 years? We've learned enormous things about what causes cancer, and because we can take blood out of the body and analyze it, understanding blood cancers in particular has really paved the way to our understanding about a whole lot of cancers. And over those 20 years, we have made curable blood cancers that we really didn't ever expect. What's been the most recent advancement in treatment? Probably the thing that excites me most in blood cancer treatments is the recognition of how the immune system can be manipulated to kill cancers. And there's a new therapy which is called chimeric antigen receptor T cell therapy, otherwise called CAR-Ts. It's incredibly exciting, the concept of being able to take out cells from the patient's body, manipulate them, put them back, and cure them. It can cure leukemias, and it can cure lymphomas, and the next treatments are directed towards patients with diseases like myeloma. So you can imagine in 5-10 years just how sophisticated this treatment's going to be, how targeted the treatment's going to be, and how many more patients we're going to be able to cure with otherwise incurable cancers. What I say to people is, this treatment that was a dream 5 years ago is now here to stay. What types of treatment options are available for your patients? Generally, when we talk about treatment options to patients, we talk to them about surgery, we talk to them about radiation treatment, we talk to them about chemotherapy, and we also talk to them about immune-based therapy, and more recently, what's called targeted therapy. Targeted therapy is about matching the right drug with the patient's particular disease and trying to make those cancer cells die by switching them off. Are there new treatments available at Epworth that aren't yet widely available across Australia? I'm really fortunate to work at Epworth because it gives me the opportunity to be able to offer patients new therapies. Right now, we have a very large clinical trials unit in the Cancer Institute, and right now we have 20 plus clinical trials for patients with different forms of blood cancers. When patients go on clinical trials, we're really trying to give them the opportunity to get access to treatments that would not be otherwise available to them. So in some ways, they're getting access to a treatment that may not be available for 2, 5, or 10 years later. What are the things that people should avoid to lower their risk? Blood cancers are really different to many other cancers in that they don't have a particular cause. We produce about 1 trillion blood cells every day. What causes most blood cancers is in fact just mistakes that are made when the body is trying to produce blood cells. And errors are made, and if those errors are not fixed, then that can result in a cell whose growth is not controlled, and that can lead to a cancer. What's the most important thing you want anyone watching this to know? I think the most important thing I want people to know when they watch this is that there's a team behind them looking after them and helping them through their journey with their blood cancer. They need to feel comfortable. They need to ask questions. They need to tell us when they're anxious and when they need help. What's the one piece of advice you would give someone who has cancer? It's a scary word. My advice is that it does need to be processed, it does need to be respected, and we recognize how scary that is. But once you've heard it, once you know about it. Once you've mapped out that journey, then you can get through it. There are some cancers that are extremely curable. We cure most of the patients, and the conversation that we have is all about how we're going to cure their disease.